We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at a very unlikely team-up, Transformers Ghostbusters, Issue 1. This is part of a storyline called Ghosts of Cybertron. Obviously it's the first part from 2019. This is written by Erik Burnham, art by Dan Schoening, colors by Luis Antonio Delgado, letters by Tom B. Long, assistant editor was Megan Brown, editors Dave Mariette and Tom Waltz. I have cover A by Dan Schoening, colors by Luis Antonio Delgado. So we very quickly learn that the Autobots fled Cybertron, leaving the Decepticons there, but something interesting happened. The Traveler showed up. Now, if you remember Ghostbusters from the 1980s, that was Gozer the Gozerian. Now, Megatron and his Decepticons attempt to attack, and, well, the Destroyer that is summoned is quite hilarious. And then there's just a black page explaining what happened. It's pretty funny. And on Earth, there is a signal and the Autobots come across it. Meanwhile, the Ghostbusters are taking down a ghost in the park. Well, things end up going pretty bizarrely, and there's a really hilarious scene where they capture a second ghost. It is outstanding. But I have to say, this was a real fun read. I was really surprised. I don't like the way the Ghostbusters are drawn. I think it's a little too silly and cartoonish. Like, it's over the top cartoonish, but everything else looks great. The Transformers look amazing, and the ghosts look cool. Ecto-1 looks good. It's just the humans are all drawn really weird, and even the two cops that we see in this one, they look okay, but the Ghostbusters themselves look really over the top silly. That's the only thing I would take issue with in here. Otherwise, most of the art is fantastic. The Transformers look awesome. They look just like they did in the 80s cartoon. The ghosts look cool, like I said. The effects look really good. The coloring's good. This is all around a pretty well put together book. My only issue is the style that the Ghostbusters are drawn. Other than that, this is a phenomenal book. I had so much fun reading this. It's got a really good plot, really well thought out. There's a decent amount of action. It's mostly a setup issue because you have to figure out how everybody's going to meet, that sort of thing. But I really enjoyed it. I thought there were some really silly moments that worked really well. Good comedic timing, and I would definitely recommend this. I thought it was a lot of fun. I didn't feel ripped off for my $4, and I'm looking forward to the second issue, which should be coming out shortly, so I'll try and have that review up as soon as possible. I also really like the cover. It's got a cool look, even though that scene doesn't happen. It's a fun look to it, so I'm really excited to see where this series goes, and hopefully the IDW continues to turn out product this good. If you're a fan of Ghostbusters or Transformers, definitely check this out. It's a lot of fun. That's just my opinion, though. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the about page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.